Yeah. Lil Brunson back at you with the back at you, and I am the best reporting on the Eagles. Listen, man, once again, man, I want to give a huge shout out to all you guys that have been out there actively buying the LB merch. I mean, orders were coming in all night, man, according to the print champs, man, and I couldn't be more pleased, man. I can't wait till you guys get that merchandise and, you know, put it on your body and show me what you guys working with. You know what I'm saying? I said that I wasn't going to buy my merchandise for myself personally until we hit a personal number sold. We've exceeded that number, and now I'm about to buy some stuff and rock out, too, with the designs that I designed for you guys, man. Can't wait, man. Shout out my guy, Baldy. You know what I'm saying? Rumors. There's always a bunch of rumors surrounding the Philadelphia Eagles, especially around this time of year. Historically, the Philadelphia Eagles have always been that franchise to, you know, get things done in mid-July. And Baldy is saying that, you know, in the foreseeable future, sometime next week, something could be happening with the Philadelphia Eagles to where a big move is made that can make them really, really good. Now, you got common moves that can always be made. You got moves like bringing Shady back. You got moves like bringing Jason Peters back. You got moves that just make sense. But when you narrow it down, there's also a lot of rumors that we've been linked to. We've been linked to Vinnie Curry. We've been linked, not Vinnie Curry, I'm sorry. We've been linked to Yannick. We've been linked to Jadeveon Clowney. We've been linked to Jamal Adams. We've been linked to Mozart. You know what I'm saying? Those type of moves right there, in my opinion, with the exception of Jadeveon Clowney, requires more capital from us. Now, the Philadelphia Eagles, you know, are in an interesting cap situation. Some would call it cap hell. I call it we need to be responsible moving forward. Now, we can't afford a Jamal Adams or a Yannick, because those guys are looking for a big contract the following year after we get them. Now, we can afford them. We can tag and trade them, which will probably be a smart move for the Philadelphia Eagles. But Jadeveon Clowney, actually, you know, with all his antics and how we may feel about him, he probably serves as the least risky guy. He holds the least risk factor. And coming over to the Philadelphia Eagles, he's calmed down, talking about he wants the $20 million. And even reconsider. Now, you see, what the NFL did, what a lot of these owners and GMs did was stall them out. Somebody could have paid them that price, but they know that these guys rather play and make $5 million and sit out and don't make anything at all. So he's come to his senses and said he's rather play for around $9 to $10 million, and that's right up our alley. That's what we can afford to do. We need to go into next season with at least $10 million in cap space so we can relieve some of that pressure of that $50 million that they're saying we're expected to have next season. Now, it's a lot of moves that can be made. It's a lot of rumors that's always swirling around us. I have no idea. Honestly, yes, Crystal Ball Brunson has no idea where this is going to go. Because if you ask me, none of those guys that I named, I would even pursue. Here's why. We didn't bring back Vinnie Curry. We got that dude Sweat just, we got him waiting. He been looking good. You know what I mean? Deshaun Hall. We got some of these guys been looking good. You know what I'm saying? Some of these guys have been putting in some work. You know what I mean? Brandon Graham is still there. You know what I'm saying? Derek Barnett, fifth-year option picked up. I don't think we're in dire need of a pass rusher as much as we think we are. But when you're talking about guys like Yannick and you're talking about guys like Jadeveon Clowney, that automatically puts you up there in a top 10 defensive front. It automatically does. Now, I talked to my guy, Mike Washington. Listen, Mike Washington firmly believes that the Washington Redskins got the best front, the best defensive front in the game. And I can't dispute that. But the Philadelphia Eagles front ain't that far off with the addition of Javon Hargrave and Fletcher Cox. Don't forget, Malik Jackson is still going to come. He didn't even play for us last year. So that's three interior bull rushers right there who are going to get a lot of pressure in these quarterback spaces. And guys off the edge like Brandon Graham, who had a really, really underrated season, in my opinion, is going to be able to do some damage right there. Now, when you talk about the Philadelphia Eagles, based upon how we're constructed, now, if we get pressure to the opposing quarterbacks, which we haven't been able to do consistently, then that gives some of our questionable cornerbacks time to get their feet under them. We gave quarterbacks and wide receiver tandems way too much time last year. We let guys run around for a while. Play action was our worst friend. We would fake to the right. We would over pursue to the right, and that quarterback would roll up to the left. He would roll out to the left and have wide open lanes to throw all over the field, a la Kirk Cousins. Kirk Cousins does it to us at will, especially in a Vikings uniform. So if you ask me, interior pressure was our main concern last season. even though the edge didn't get there. It's easy for the edge to not get there when the interior is not getting there as well. Fletcher Cox, Javon Hargrave are going to be difference makers along with Malik Jackson, who we didn't really get to see at all. So Yannick and Clowney really don't make that sense to me from a personnel standpoint. But Clowney is the best option because it doesn't hurt us as much in the long run. If we get Yannick, we will be forced to tag and trade Yannick. We will be forced to tag and trade him. We cannot just go out there and trade for Yannick because you're going to lose assets when you go get Yannick or Jamal. You're going to lose assets. We can't afford those assets because of the cap situation we're in. Our team is going to look very different next year. This will be the last time, the last season, that we're going to look as dominant from a roster standpoint. People already don't think we look that good as well. But there will be some new rookies coming in next season. Not the season that we're on the brink of. I'm talking about the 2021 season. There will be some rookies coming in to replace some of these big name guys. I'm not saying, this is just an example. Brandon Brooks could possibly not be here. We might have to release him to eat some of that bread. Alshon Jeffrey could not be here. And another thing, Bleacher Report, the video I did yesterday on Bleacher Report saying that, you know, Carson Wentz was the highest paid player on the team that had the most overbearing contract. Well, he's one of the highest paid, but Bleacher Report was saying that his contract hurts the team the most in a nutshell. Well, what about Malik Jackson, who didn't even play? What about Alshon Jeffrey? There's more contracts that you can say that are damaging to the Philadelphia Eagles roster besides Carson Wentz. It absolutely makes no sense. You got to lock up a guy like Carson Wentz. You got to lock him up. Now, I've been looking a lot at Carson Wentz and other quarterbacks' highlight tapes from 2019. Everybody ain't make them throws Carson Wentz made. And we just going to leave that at that. You know what I'm saying? But as far as these moves that everybody is saying that the Philadelphia Eagles are going to make, listen, man, we got to wait and see. Because if Baldy is saying that we are talking about moves that are going to make us a completely better football team, then it's got to be somebody coming in with some star power. Let me know what you think in the comments.